Wellness can be defined as a dynamic process of change and growth. It is a state of complete physical, mental, and social well-being. As we navigate through our stressful day-to-day lives, it is easy to neglect certain aspects of our well-being. As a result, we experience emotions such as anxiety, depression, and feeling overwhelmed with the stress that comes with all the complex, moving parts of our lives. The never-ending list of things to do, which seems to continue to pile up, often leaves us feeling drained or in an altered mental state. How do we combat this issue? Despite balancing a seemingly endless number of responsibilities, we find that taking care of ourselves in these three aspects can help us battle the stress of everyday life and continue to grow and prosper into better versions of ourselves. This is the Wellness Documentary.
When I think of wellness, it's more so like a state of being, like you're happy a lot of the time, but you also feel fulfilled in what you're doing, or it's not momentary moments of happiness, it's a joy almost.
Right. I typically feel my best when all kind of components of my life are under control. Like I'm doing everything I need to keep my physical in check, like working out and lifting. And then also that helps with my mental, making sure I'm not too stressed or feeling so overwhelmed. And then also my social, the social aspect of wellness being spending time with friends and family. And having those moments where you can relax, take a step back from everything, and just enjoy the present moment.
In your experience, how do you keep that balance between the physical, mental, and social health aspects of your life?
To keep it a balance, I'd say, is definitely something I've struggled with, especially this year, our senior year. It's been the busiest time of my life ever. Mm-hmm. Balancing, I think of making sure I get a workout in every day, finding time to get it in whenever, whether it's before school or after school, or whether it's basketball practice, kind of whatever it looks like. Getting some sort of physical activity always helps.
I think it's really important that you're maintaining exercise at least 4 to 5 times a week, just to make sure you're feeling good about your body and your health. Trying to have at least one practice or one workout a day is something that's really good towards that.
Right. What does weightlifting do for your mental health?
For me, it is a stress reliever, but it also allows me to just be fit and stay in shape. For me being a PE teacher, I think it's important that I play the part as well.
What does the whole never settle mindset kind of mean to you?
For me, as a, as a coach, as a teacher, I don't want to settle as in, knowing everything. I want to continue to learn. I want to continue to just, get stronger, fit. There's just always improvement in your life. You just don't never want to settle, because from there on, then you just don't have nothing to look forward to. And I always want to look forward to better myself and others as well.
Sweet. That's perfect. Thank you very much. Appreciate it. When you're lifting and you're setting new goals and, becoming the best version of yourself, it's really motivating and helps pretty much every other aspect of your life.
And I think just having the willpower to get up every day, especially when you're lifting at 6:30 in the morning, having the willpower to be able to get out of bed every day and say, right now I may not see the results, but the results are going to be coming down in the future, and those results are going to be worth it. And so having that is important in life, because later on when you may be in a job that you don't appreciate, or a time in your life where stuff is really hard, you can look at that and say, I may not like it now, but this will definitely help me in the future. And so I think it's important that this is a good way of a non-high risk environment of being able to build those habits.
No friends in the industry, my brothers been my brothers, man, you ain't no kidding me, a fact. Well, yeah, you heard about me, you don't know me more than that. Yeah, I know I, hey, yeah. No friends in the industry, my brothers been my brothers, man, you ain't no kidding me, a fact. Whoa, I was known for snapping when I chat before the app. Stood on everything I said and never took it back, whoa. No friends in the industry, I had to draw the line between my brothers and my enemies, a fact. Let us start to beat, don't wanna keep it wrapped. Yeah, you hit us up and now we owe you something back. See, I was young, angel, but these turn me evil. Yeah, I know you, but you really ain't my people. Yeah, I heard some people say they know him as my equal. Truth be told, our son is...
The mental aspect, I'd say making sure I'm always on top of my schoolwork. We've had so much stuff to do applying to schools, it's been stressful.
I also find that getting my homework done first and getting it out of the way before doing that is something that's very beneficial to me, because then I can relax more. Right. I don't have stuff to worry about that hinders how well I relax.
And so I think that like making sure that I'm getting stuff done on a daily basis, daily and consistent basis, that helps keep my mental in check.
I definitely focus on having a routine because otherwise I'm stressed out all the time.
But try to sleep as much as you can, and so you can actually come to school with energy and actually do your work and make sure to eat breakfast.
What does art do for you and your mental health?
Oh, well, if you were to ask my husband and my children what art does for me, and all of us living together, they'll say, if I go a week without having time to make art in my studio, I'm a terrible person to live with. Terrible. It makes me relax. I can sort through things. I can express myself and say things in my art I can't say to people. And it really helps me process things. Yeah, it helps me stay calm and I can really focus. Because we need to clear things out of our brains, and art does that for me. I can clear everything out of my brain, and I can focus when I'm making art. I love that. It feels good, too, when you're in the zone. You know, like an athlete, you're an athlete, and you're working out, and you're feeling so good, and suddenly hours have gone by, and it's just been awesome. Well, it's the same for me in my studio.
And social, I think that... that aspect is kind of taken care of at school, like hanging out with friends, we'll be messing around in class, and it's just like some of those like little moments that we have every day just kind of like help us push through, even if it's like a tough day or we have like a big task coming up, like just like totally. Spending time with friends at lunch totally helps. So
yeah, I think that's a very important thing. Just the times we find in class to make jokes or to laugh with friends is very good to maintaining our mental health.
Right. The amount of mustard this man consumes on a daily basis.
Let's go, mustard!
The amount of energy
this
takes. Yeah, I'm like 5 minutes away.
Why are you running this late, so late?
Because I woke up late.
Wow.
Break doesn't start till Monday.
Why
is
everyone laughing?
Alright, we'll see when you get here.
Oh, hi. Welcome back to CAS. Follow your dreams. Yeah. Wanna get a mansion, a jacuzzi, a theater to watch my movies, couple whips and lots of fancy things.
Work
kids they call
the money.
See the future, crystal ball. Mirror,
that's
mirror, hanging on the wall. Got your girlfriend screening all the calls. She bubbling, we f***ing and you cuddling. Like baby, where the f*** you been? I wanna tell you she in love with him. So we ain't saying nothing. You could probably tell she bluffing, cause she kissed you with the mouth. She gave me with my concussion. Yeah, she blushing all red. Wanna rush and go to bed. You interrogate that b- like you the feds. So she says she in love with a rock star. Rock star wanna smoke my weed. So she asked me where the tops are. Tops are.
Oh,
top drawer.
Practice like you've never won, play like you've never lost.
Deep.
Wow.
Just enjoy the moment, you know? It goes by fast for sure. Just live in the moment.
Yep.
Oh, get the backpack. Right, get the backpack.
Oh, get the backpack?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
What are some things that
in your opinion, are the best ways to like stay motivated and to keep that good work, life, school balance?
Well, motivation, I think, is easier to sustain when the activities that you're involved in support and line up with what you value as a person. For example, my work as a teacher, it is easy for me to stay motivated to come to school because one of my key values is investing in other people is an essential thing to bring happiness to my own life. Like if I'm self-focused and self-centered, I tend to implode. Mm-hmm. And I think most lives, I would say that most lives do.
Yeah.
Like if we are investing in other people, that brings value to our own efforts. So when my activities line up with my values, it's easier to stay motivated. Mm-hmm. As far as balancing all the different things, being able to say no is a skill I did not learn until deep after high school because I had a severe fear of missing out. So I said yes to everything. So that balance of understanding like what are the priorities in this season of my life and then saying no to the things that don't line up with them.
Can you talk a little bit more so about why you personally choose to be so exuberant and happy every day?
Part of it is just my personality. Like I'm an extrovert, so I get energy from being around people. One of the things that about Link Crew that lines up just with who I am as a person is the whole idea of yes and, like having a yes and attitude, accepting reality for what it is, considering my response and then building in a positive direction. Like that's just how I approach life. You're going to be a thermometer or you're going to be a thermostat. People either go to the common feel in the room or they change the feel in the room. Most of the time I'm like, hey, life is more enjoyable if there is a smile and a laugh. Not that every situation is a joke. That's mm-hmm. certainly not true. But when kids know, I am glad that you as a person are here and we're going to have a good time and get some stuff done.
Totally.
That's what I do.
While IB may be stressful, one of the best parts about it is the bonds that you create with your fellow students.
Definitely.
I know just even people that I haven't talked to or wouldn't talk to outside of IB have become some of my closest friends just for the simple fact that they're going through the same struggles as me.
When I look back at like my high school experience, a lot of like the best moments have been like nights after games at like Sherry's or Denny's, like just grabbing food with friends. Some of those like nights where you don't really think about it, where things are spontaneous, end up being some like the small moments, that make it worth it. I'm drunk. But not-